Okay, so it started.
Oh, wait, let me join you. Oops. Go public, please. All right.
Yeah, so I've started, okay?
Okay, if you could also go public, then I can jump in and join you. I guess we haven't tested the tracks or anything.
Okay, we can do this shit anyway. Okay, so I'm public and live. Is that cool?
I guess.
Might as well. Let's do this. This is the randomness. Oh, yeah, I need to go public, so boom.
Yeah.
Okay. Come and join me, Ozan.
Yeah, I'm going to come in. Let's see if I can get this going here. Logging in, connecting. Hopefully all is good. All right. Yes, I can hear loud and clear. Let me see if I can figure out how to get to one of the sides here. I'm going to try and get on your other side this time.
Yeah.
Just because I have some different setup. This works pretty well.
Yeah.
I'm just kind of lurking on the side here.
I've got a bit of an echo, by the way.
Oh, here, I'll let me mute. Hang on.
If you're just joining us, guys, or you're watching this after the live stream, we're just getting stuff set up, okay? So to tell you what's going on, if this is the first time you've ever seen this kind of thing, this is in virtual reality. We're in an app known as Tribe, which is through Oculus. And I have in front of me Club Standard Kit. Ozan is to my right. He's in San Francisco, and I'm in Wales. And we're doing this...
Whoa, whoa.
Whoa, whoa, yeah. And we're using some Cryoman tunes. I love the start of that, by the way. Let's just cue that up again.
Awesome, yeah. It's fun, man. It's got a funky
vibe. Yeah, it's quite techie as well.
Yeah.
It's got remnants, you know, the old-style kind of early house music. Really sort of experimental. Love it.
Yeah.
To the hip hop, hip to the hip of the hip, hip a hoppy, you don't stop a racket to the hip hop, hip to the hip of the hip, hip a hoppy, you don't stop a racket to the hip hop. So if you just join us, just hold tight for a second. Ozan's getting his shit together. Then Ozan will look at the chat and we'll be able to give some live Q&A and talk to you. And today's stream is about like getting into Ibiza, about Ibiza. I mean, I know a little bit, I'm sure. People watching know a little bit, a great deal more than me, but it's just talking about Ibiza. And I mean, Ozan, what do you know about Ibiza?
You know, I don't know much. It's a mythical place that I've been in some exotic remote location where all the girls are and all the music is, and it's a place that I really want to go to someday.
take a bunch of money.
Yeah, lose all my money.
Oh, yeah.
How to lose all your money in Ibiza.
Take a bunch of money, man.
I'm going to do it. Do it, do it. Okay, so last thing I'm going to do just to kind of get this party going here is I'm going to jump out of the call. Okay, so I think I'm ready to rumble.
Cool.
We're good to go. We got it all going here.
We got it going on. Well, yeah.
So Cafe Mambo. I heard Luke was saying that Cafe Mambo is the place to go, and I have heard of Cafe Mambo. Right, that's one of the spots, right?
Cafe Mambo, let's have a look. You've also got, I think it's Savannah Beach.
Savannah Beach?
Yeah, this is like, it's a nightclub, again, beach, guess where it is, you know? And
gotcha.
It's a lot of places in Ibiza, you've got your clubs, which are sort of inside, or parts of the clubs, which have an inside room, but a lot of them are right, like outside. I mean, come on, we're Mediterranean, you know, if it rains,
it
hammers it down, but then everything, all the electrics are pretty much covered over. So if people are dancing and it's raining, it's like, whoa, just bring it on. In fact, people like that. They open their mouths and get the water because a bottle of water costs money in Ibiza, you know?
nice. KDYN in the house. Shout out to KDYN. What up?
KDYN, how you doing?
Yeah.
Okay.
You know, so Katie's the one that you spoke with last week. He's the 13-year-old producer.
Man. Well, good to see you again. Yeah. Nice one. Thank you for coming back.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay. And then Luke also is on the sort of on the chat, and he's 17 and also producing. He's like tech house tracks. He's t- totally so talented.
If it looks like I'm walking into the depths, I'm not. I'm trying to move away and in and out of kit all over the room, and there's shit everywhere. But you know, man, this is real life. I mean, crikey,
it's real. Yeah, keeping it real. But look at this, man. Amazing, right? So one of the things that we wanted to talk about, let's see, let me kind of get myself situated here. We got Cryoman playing now.
Yeah.
Part of the reason why we wanted to talk about Ibiza is that one of our early partners on this project was DJ Cryoman. Tom met him, and he came to visit us. It was actually a really pretty impressive entry. We're based in San Francisco. We met up in Sausalito, which is by the bay, right by the Golden Gate Bridge.
Nice.
And he came in on a private seaplane.
Wow.
He came in on a private seaplane, landed in the bay, got up on the dock, and came and had breakfast with us. That was a rock star move.
That is pretty cool.
Yeah. It turned out to be a little bit not so glamorous, in the sense that it's like there is an Uber of seaplanes that you can rent and go from lake to lake. So he went from Lake Tahoe to the Bay, basically.
Yeah, but
that's how we met him.
But it's still cool, better than getting a taxi.
Yeah. Yeah, exactly. It's a little bit like getting a really glamorous taxi. And then, but he was telling us about his, how he came. He said he came up in Ibiza, that's where he got his chops.
Yeah.
So we're playing his tracks now. We wanted to talk a little bit about Ibiza.
So yeah, I mean, guys, watching, ask us, during the stream, ask us questions as well. Fire away.
Yeah. So one thing we want to do is, so the title of the show is How to Hack Ibiza. How do you get into Ibiza? How do you get into the clubs? And how do you have your moment there, because it's such a classic destination.
It is. Something I've always said to many people, and that is, if you think about life, there is what you can do legally, what you can't do, which is very illegal. So let's imagine, all right, let's look at these decks here. And in fact, I think this is going to be a good analogy. The right-hand deck, this CD player, you can touch everything. You can mess around, do whatever you want. The mixer is like this thin line, okay, where you got to be careful. This deck here is a big no-no. You don't do that shit, all right? So let's imagine this kit is Ibiza. Over here, you can go to Ibiza. You get a plane, you book into a hotel, you pay your money for drinks, you go to the beach, you party, and so on. Whereas over here, you rob someone, you do drugs, you take your clothes off, you run up and down the street, you're gonna get arrested. Shit's gonna happen, okay? That's the no-no. But this is what I'm gonna concentrate right now, is on that middle bit, okay? The middle, to me, is the important part, okay? Just check, make sure everything's all right down there. Yeah, okay, so the middle part is important. So how do you hack Ibiza? What's the best thing to do? I just need to put something down there. Okay, now, a lot of people are always asking me, how can I get into a nightclub? How can I work in a big nightclub? Well, let's elaborate on that. How can you work in Ibiza? How can you be heard and seen in Ibiza? Now, if you want to get into a smaller nightclub in Ibiza, don't start in June, July, or August. It's too late. Shit's too late, man. It's happened. It's been and gone. You need to start thinking about it now. So what I would be doing, I would be booking flights, I'd be finding accommodation, maybe campsite, somewhere that's relatively cheap and inexpensive, and going maybe April, May, early June, and taking your music with you, taking your headphones with you. I would then be going to bars, small bars along the beaches, and approaching management and saying, listen here, this is what I can do. Show them maybe some links to sets you've done online, where you've worked, and ask them, say, listen, I'll work for food. Let me just do a little set for an hour during the day and see what happens. The crazy thing with Ibiza, it's not like a lot of places where nightclubs and bars open, say, midday, and the music starts at 7 in the evening. I mean, a lot of places are open all the time. There's always music being played. So they've got to fill that time. And if you've got a DJ who is willing to play just to be heard, there's a good chance the manager will go, well, all right, yeah, we've got nothing to lose. So potentially, by you pushing that little, pushing the envelope a little bit, you could get yourself set in a small cafe bar somewhere along the beach. People come along, they hear you, they groove to you, they dance, they stay, they drink, they party. Management go, man, this kid's good. We like this kid because he or she is bringing in the crowds, or the crowds are staying here. And then, you know, you've got your foot in the door. Yeah, you like that?
Yeah. I love the poetry, man. I love the description. So yeah, KDYN, we'll see you later. DJ Obsession, this is basically a virtual reality experience. We're like simulating the DJ experience inside virtual reality. And the cool thing is that we're global right now. I'm based in San Francisco, and Eliskins, you're in the UK.
Yep.
And the fact that we can connect like this is pretty outrageous. So it's cool.
We're using Cryoman tracks as well. And this is the first time I've heard these tunes as well. So Cryoman is a very good friend of Ozan. And this guy, a DJ stroke producer, I mean, he pretty much originated, as far as I know, in Ibiza. And that's where, am I right in saying that's where his roots started and he got his name?
Yeah.
Okay. And
yeah, that's where he came up.
Cool.
And then one thing I noticed is that when we got these tracks, you know, we pulled them down off Beatport, actually. And I think they fall into the progressive house, electro house genre. So it's like, it's pretty aggressive, hard edge.
Yeah.
Not quite big room, but yeah, it's good.
No. Yeah, that's it. They are. They're more sort of a progressive type, whereas big room is more the breaks. A big build down in a break and a big build up with loads of instruments, vocals, melody. Whereas this is a little bit more like what I'm picturing here. If I could take this track into an image or a movie, it would be someone riding on a horse really fast doing like this. Is that, you know what I mean? Or on a motorbike.
There's some muscle in there, you know? It's very masculine in some way.
Hard drive.
You know?
Yeah, love it.
Yeah.
Let's find something else. Okay, I'm just flicking through these tracks now. So again, what we're doing here in virtual reality, again, this is Tribe, is in front of me here. I have a list of the tracks that we're using today. And if you don't have any of your own tracks and you're interested in, you know, getting Tribe, you don't even have to have your own music because the music's here. It's right in front of you. So you can go up here, you can click through the tracks, you load to the right deck, you load to the left deck. You have your mixer in front of you, you use the right channel for the right deck, left for the left deck. You have headphones, so you can set headphone cue. You can sync if you want to, you can use the pitch, you can play, pause, hot cue, loop, effects.
Eliskins, real quick, so Chase was asking about how it feels to play the CDJs in VR. How's the feel? What's it like?
It takes a lot of getting used to, man. It does, and that's not a bad thing. It's actually a good thing because once you do get used to it, you can come in, you can turn on your laptop, and within less than 5 minutes, you're in VR and you're partying with an entire setup. And guess what? Instead of then, if you're in, let's say you're in a bedsit with minimal room, you know, you haven't got to worry about setting the kit up. You know, you can pretty much just stop, take your headphones off, your headset, and you're back with nothing, no wires, no cables. It's crazy.
Yeah, it's crazy. And the social fact, the fact that we can kind of conference together,
yes.
The fact that we can connect like this and have this shared experience is pretty amazing.
Yeah, that's right. So for example, you could have a friend who's got a VR setup, also got Tribe, who's really into their music style, but they're in Australia and you're in Scotland. It doesn't matter. So long as you're awake at the same time, you can be in the same room as Ozan and I are now. Ozan's in California, San Francisco. I'm in Wales, middle of nowhere, man. I'm like, this guy's right next to me. I mean, I could...
Yeah.
Ooh.
Yeah, it's
this
pretty
is,
amazing.
This is dirty.
This is a fat track.
This is dirty, man.
What do you guys think of the music? So the guys on chat, what do you guys think of these tracks? Stuart, you know, a good place to buy tracks. For me, Beatport has been an amazing source. I guess there's a bunch of record pools. Jonathan, you get your tracks from a bunch of different places, but
yeah,
you know, some record pools. I think Beatport is a good one, though. They have a great UI, a great way of like organizing your tracks.
I use ZipDJ a lot of the time because you can get pretty much what you want. They've got house, hip-hop, soul, R&B, techno, trance. They've even got country, man, you know, and the great thing with ZipDJ is you pay a fee per month and you can just fill your boots, yeah?
Yeah. Yeah, that's the cool thing about, like, a subscription approach. Because that is, like, endless appetite for tracks, you know? Oh. Chase, what are your questions? You got a ton of tracks, questions for VR. Lay them on us. Let's see if we can get through them. Deep Medi, Jarimbo, Deep Medi. Yeah, it would be cool to check that out. Maybe we could do like some shows on that.
Sure. Okay, yeah. So again, Ibiza. You know, you've got David Guetta, you've got your Hardwells who go there. And the thing is with Ibiza and the DJs, how can I put it? It's good to go to, you know, Amnesia, Pasha, places like that. But it's, oh shit, is Pasha still going? Let me think. Yeah, I'm sure it is. Now, these places, I've got to tell you a story. Well, there's a few stories about Ibiza. I've only been there once, first of all, but believe me, that was an experience.
How was it? Tell us, like, when you arrived, what was it like?
The arrival was crazy because I'd like to start with the flight, okay? I'm flying into Ibiza and, you know, we're descending. And I swear to God, okay, it is the worst descent I've had in my life. We hit a thunderstorm and, man, the plane, it was, if you imagine sitting in a seat and having two people pick the seat up, one either side of you, and banging it on the floor. It was douche, 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 like this. And there was a couple to my right, newlyweds, and the girl was crying her eyes out. She was scared. And I was sitting there in the plane going, what a way to go. You know? But then when we landed...
This is how it ends.
Yeah, when we landed, though, it was like, okay, gray sky up there. But it was warm, really humid, you know? Had a taxi pick me up, went to a villa, and this was with a company that I was sort of helping out at the time. There was this app, a piece of hardware for called a Nextbeat, and it was a controller with a handheld device. You could load two tracks on, pick it up, and you could do a mix via Bluetooth on this controller, put it back in, load up two more tracks, and so on. So they invited me over there. Met Lenny Fontana for the first time, went to Amnesia, watched Roger Sanchez, and even that in itself was an experience because, again, the crazy thing with Ibiza is, quite a few places around the world, nightclubs don't get going till, you know, maybe 11, 12 o'clock. But we turned up in Amnesia at like 1:30, 2 o'clock in the morning, and I walked in, I'm like, man, this is shit, it's dead. You know, it was quiet. There was people dancing, drunk, enjoying themselves, but it was quiet. By 4 o'clock in the morning, it was rammed. It was just crazy. Absolutely, it was full, man. It was just
a different time zone.
Oh yeah, it was mental. And over there, okay, a lot of people will...
Pause for 1 second. So just to answer a few questions. So Chase was asking about if the CDJs are fully interactable.
What, these players?
The answer is yes.
Yes, yeah. They are. Yeah, let's quickly give you a demonstration. So, if I go now into what we call CDJ mode, you can hear. Let me just put the volume up. I can slow it down. So, okay, so it's exactly like jogging it slower and speeding it up. Okay, let's speed it up, slow it down. Oh, actually, I'm in sync. So, there. Now you can hear that speeding up and slowing down. We can put key lock on. Now it slows down, stays the same key, speeds up. We can do a loop.
Maybe avoid the master tempo, sure. Just because there's a known issue for that. Yeah.
Okay, no worries. Cue it up. We can set cue points. So, you know, a lot of the features on this virtual turntable are exactly the same as the high-end kit you'd expect to have in a nightclub.
Yeah. All you know, one thing, so let's see, 7-Down 8-Up was asking about the middle faders, the 2 and 3. So yeah, I mean, the mixer supports 4 decks, and we wanted to model the high-end DJ gear. So this is modeled after the Nexus 900. And so you get the feel of what it's like to play on club standard kit.
Yeah.
But we don't have 4 decks set up just now. We can eventually at some point, but for now, basically we just have the two channels working. But there are folks that want to do like 4 deck mixing. Like I know Luke does a lot of like really interesting creative stuff with, you know, a third sound source, a third deck or something like that.
Yeah.
So
do you know,
at some point.
What I could see happening, and I'm sure this is possible, and again, guys, this is something that, you know, technology is always moving forward. You know, we could talk about a great tech right now about technology, something A, and after the conversation, the people who've invented technology A have updated it to A1, even while you're talking. So what I can picture happening with Tribe is, yeah, you've got 4 decks and you've got 1 mixer, but then I can see, and possibly an idea, Ozan, is, you know, for like, Ozan is in California, yeah? San Francisco, yep. I'm in Wales.
California, man. I'm in California. I just went surfing, but now I'm hanging out with you.
Hey, baby. But hey, check baby. This out. I could potentially be on deck 1 and 2, on 2 channels, headphones queued up, listening, and you could be on deck 3 and 4, and we could be doing a back-to-back mix, 2 decks this side, 2 decks that side. I mean, that's not impossible, is it?
It would. In fact, we're working on it now. We got the first version of back-to-back DJing done, a prototype done, and we did a test with Let's Manu, who's one of our part of our crew, where he's in Austria and I'm in San Francisco, and we did it, man. We jumped into a session and he's mixing, you know, on deck 1, and then I'm mixing and we're like, you know, doing the effects, and then I throw on a track on deck 2 and we do like, you know, a beat matched mix from one track into the other across the globe. I mean, it was a bit of a head trip so in the coming, I don't know, I would say in the next few weeks we're gonna have a version that's ready for back-to-back DJing, so you and I could do that, you know.
That would be so
upcoming
cool
upcoming show. Yeah, that'd be awesome.
And you'd have seen it here first, okay, even though it's already been done. Okay. All right. Do you remember I told you about this, the middle bit? If you've just tuned in and joined us, welcome to Ellerskins. We're again in VR courtesy of Ozan, very good friend of mine, even though I've never met the guy, from the States. And
in the flesh and blood.
Oh yeah, we will one day, dude. Again, how to hack Ibiza? How'd you get into Ibiza? Now, a lot of people are thinking, okay, there's no chance of me ever playing a DJ set in Ibiza. Well, the only thing stopping you is you. Okay, so if we go back 20 years, it would probably be very difficult for you to be a DJ in Ibiza unless you knew a manager or you were able to do, as I said earlier, go there early, take your records and hassle management and eventually get your foot in the door. But you see, what you can do with today's technology is just think very logically here. Pioneer, Newmark, Mixtrack Pro, the likes, they've got these controllers that are bus powered. So bus powered very quickly means you don't need any external power. You just use the power from your laptop. So just think out loud. You take your headphones with you. You take a controller with you. You take your laptop. You take like a mini rig, a small powered speaker, something that pushes that sound out. You go to Ibiza. You sit on the beach. You have your headphones on, your controller in front of you, your laptop up. You plug your speaker in. You do a little bit of a mix there. This is Ibiza, man. Shit happens, you know? If the sound's good, there's a few people around you, you never know, they may start dancing. Otherwise, again, it's that thin line. Just get in there, get your face in there. You go to where people are. You know, don't just stand there where no one is. Go to where a crowd of people are. You know, maybe there's a few people like drinking some beers, having pina coladas. You know, they're sat there, they're playing basketball. Go next to them and start playing some music. You see, what you've got to think of is if you create a vibe, if you create some energy where you are and people start vibing to that energy and getting into it, more people are going to come, and more, because people, they're like sheep, man. I mean, they people want to see what's going on if there's a crowd of people. And if you create a crowd, some energy, then people are coming, are going to come in and come in, and then you never know. Shit might happen.
You know what's amazing about that, man? That takes cojones to just go out there and put yourself out there and start playing music. And
yeah, but
I mean, it takes big balls to do it. And I guess also just vibing the audience, like vibing the feedback.
Yeah.
Just, hey, is this working? Because there's a chance it may not work. You're like, maybe the style's not right. Maybe the moment's not right. And you have to sense it. But if the moment is right, then you can double down on it, and then good things happen. Then you have your good moment.
You got it. You know, again, this is the difference between the people that do and the people that don't. The people that don't are the ones like, I can't do that. People will look at me. People will laugh. I mean, if I do that, wow, everyone's going to look at me and I'm going to be the center of attention and I'm shy. It's like, okay, if that's your attitude, then just stick it, stay inside your bedroom and you could do these wonderful mixes. And you know what? Forget it. Okay. On the other hand, if you're the sort of DJ who's average, you can do a good mix, you've got some sort of structure in your set, and you're like, you know what? I don't give a shit what people think of me. Those are the people I like, all right? I mean,
You know, I was just going to say, one thing I've experienced with this so far is that, like, you know, DJing in VR is, it's unexpected. It was never intended to, you know, replace the decks. So I think Chase was mentioning about, like, it's not supposed to, it wasn't, you know, the purpose of it, it wasn't to replace the hardware. It's to accent the hardware, to complement the hardware. So you can, you know, extend the hardware. You can do things you can never do in real life.
One thing
I've noticed right now is streaming in VR is this amazing thing because you have the headset on, you have the avatar. Yes, it's you. Yes, it's me. We kind of know our real identity.
Yeah.
But we're kind of safe. You know, we can play to people.
Yes.
We're kind of, there's a little bit of safety in doing it.
Yeah.
So you get the best of both worlds. You can stream and connect with people live, but you're in the comfort and safety of your own home.
That's
right. Worst case scenario, just fucking turn off the computer, pretend it never happened, you know?
Yeah. And also, for example, let's imagine, which is very likely, maybe not now, but maybe in 6 months, there'll be a young man, a young lady watching this stream who is, really shy. Maybe you're housebound. Maybe you don't even want to go outside, but you love music, you love vibe, and you want to DJ in front of people. Well, the way this technology is moving forward, maybe you're scared to show your face. Maybe you've got a blemish in your face. Maybe your nose is in the wrong place or your eyes are twisted. I don't know. I mean, I'm not taking the piss here. I'm not making fun. I'm just saying that you're scared of your appearance. In VR, you don't have to be, because you can be who you want to be. You can bring this avatar on. All of a sudden, you are this image that you've made yourself in VR, and you can have the best time of your life. And like Ozan said, no one knows who you are. You don't have to give any personal information. You can just be who you want to be, and you're enjoying the music. And if you're good at it, other people enjoy the music with you as well. So cool.
And the cool thing is that we're still connecting. I mean, the folks that are on chat are like, you know, asking really good questions, and there's a definite connection that happens. So I think it's really cool. One thing I wanted to mention, so Chase mentioned playing in Fortnite. So this weekend there was this event where Marshmallow DJed live in Fortnite.
Yeah.
And if you don't know, Fortnite is, you know, a massively popular game. Apparently every single teenager in the world is playing Fortnite right now. And so Marshmallow did this set, and it was this special event, and there's a buzz about it, and we were definitely excited to go check it out, and we did, and it was pretty dope. I mean, the production quality was really good.
Cool.
His avatar looked really good. His avatar is tailor-made. I mean, his persona is tailor-made for Fortnite. It's tailor-made for having an avatar. It's just, he's got that Marshmallow head. He's got that all-white outfit. So he looked really good. The track was really good. Apparently, like, millions of people watched it. Like, they peaked at about 10 million people watching the event simultaneously.
That's pretty cool.
Which is pretty nutballs, you know?
Yeah.
There were some technical issues in how they instanced the servers. So it wasn't like you had a million people in the same space. You had clusters of about 100 people spread across thousands of servers.
Wow.
But apparently like a million people. It was nutballs. But the one thing I noticed is that it was canned. I don't know how else to put it. It was not live. It wasn't the way you're doing it right now. It wasn't like Marshmallow was, interacting with virtual gear. He was like, his character was there. He had animation cycles. You know, the cycles were not quite in sync with the music. He was clapping randomly. He was fist bumping. it's possible he wasn't even there. It's possible that, you know, he was all just scripted and recorded.
That's a shame. That's a shame.
I mean, it's just it. I mean, no, I suspect he was there. At least, you know, he was watching. Maybe he pushed play to start the whole thing. But it wasn't like he was, you know, live. So I think that's part of the reason why maybe, you know, some folks on chat are saying it was lackluster, because it wasn't quite, you know, the live experience. But for most people, it didn't matter. It was just a hype experience. So, yeah.
That is a shame. I mean, a story I'd like to tell you about, which... again, is great, and hopefully this will inspire a few people out there, because that's what Ellerskins is about. It's about kicking your mother frigging butt and inspiration. So if you could see my feet now, big kick, just mind the computer. There's a guy called Louis. This guy's 17, okay? True story. And about 2 or 3 weeks ago, I went to Get in a Mix in Colchester. There was an event on Monday evening called the NADJ Show, which is the National Association of Disc Jockeys, and it was that area's kind of meeting. And this young guy, I know him, I've met him before, and his dad, he turned up and he did a bit of a set on the Pioneer controller, the effects controller, the SDJ 1000. There were the two Nexus Mark II DJM 900 mixer. Now, what he did, he had record box, he had the beat grid set, he had a loop set, he had hot cues. But what he did, his set, okay, is he mixed a house tune into an 80s track, from an 80s track into Madonna kind of, and then into Michael Jackson, and back into some house tune. And then he whopped in a dubstep tune into a drum and bass track back into house. But this guy was chopping it up, man. He was going for it, hell to leather. And the mix was dope. It was amazing. Now, I had an email from his dad, and this hopefully will be inspiring news to everyone out there. And bearing in mind, this guy is only 17, okay? He was at another shop in London, I believe, about a week ago, and he did a set. As soon as he finished, the guys from Denon were on him like a rash, going, listen, we want you. What do you want? They wanted awesome. A piece of his ass, man. They were like, come on. Because they can see the potential in him. Now, there's the story. But really, the story I'm explaining is not about him and Denon getting hold of him. It's about his set, what he did. Because a lot of new DJs now are thinking, right, okay, my techno mix has got to be pristine. It's got to be flowing, and it's got to be vibrant, and it's got to have this flowing energy. Now, there's nothing wrong with that. But this 17-year-old, he mashed up music. He mashed it all up. He didn't do techno. He didn't do house. He didn't do old school. He did everything together. Melodically, it was flawless. The mixing was perfect. It was on time, on phrase, in key. Energy levels rose smoothly. It was a creation. It was a masterpiece. And that guy was he could have been signed there and then, pretty much. So what I'm saying here is don't think, you know, don't think in that tiny box. Think all the way around you. What I've always said to people is take what you've got. Look at other DJs. Don't follow other DJs, but take bits. Imagine you're making, you're cooking, and all of a sudden you're a chef, you're in a restaurant, and you know, you want that Michelin star, man. You've got to have that Michelin star. If you look in a cookbook and design something that's already been made, forget it, man. You're going to get jack shit. But if all of a sudden you rip that cookbook up, you throw it away, you go into the cupboard and you say, right, let's smell this. It smells good. That's good. That'll work with that. Let's put those two together. You know what? I've just added these two ingredients. Let's get some flavoring. Let's put that in. Bit of salt. No, not too much. Okay, add some pepper. Let's get some olive oil. Let's not just get olive oil. Let's get, you know, olive oil from a certain region of Italy, because that's the best flavor to go with what I've just added. Really think deep and hard into what you're doing. This is what this guy was doing. He wasn't just compiling a mix and I'll just randomly throw Michael Jackson in. He really thought about where Michael Jackson had to be inside the house tune. And then all of a sudden, awesome. He built it up. So he was making something. That guy, That guy's mix was a Michelin star, and he does this every single set. So that's what you've got to do. Think outside the box, man.
That's cool, man. I suspect that you're speaking right to Luke's heart, because he's a 17-year-old aspiring a producer and DJ. And man, Luke, I wish that you have that experience too, you know, from
Ellis Skin's
lips to God's ears. Caleb, just real quick, there's some info in the description. Caleb, just jump on our Discord and we'll set you up. I can set you up. My name is Ozan, and I can give you a quick intro and stuff like that. And then, you know, just one last thing. I love what Stuart Robson was saying. I mean, it's basically about the passion, you know? He's 54 and he's working on his first gig in Bournemouth. And it's like, fucking A, for sure, man. Life is short.
Oh, yeah.
And music is this just magical, almost religious, mysterious thing. It's like, just there's no time like the present, you know? No. Whether you're young or old, it's like, just do it.
Yeah, but what is old? I mean, you know, 54. Okay, how old's Carl Cox? He's nearly 60. Okay.
Awesome.
He's nearly 60.
And he's still rocking it.
And he's still, you know, the music and age, I'm sorry, no boundaries. Like I've said many times, and people will notice, you know, you're too old when you're dead. But believe me, even when you're dead, your spirit is just still going to be rocking to those good vibes, man.
You know, one thing I noticed too is that memory has this way of being timeless. Like if you do something awesome, it kind of doesn't matter if you did it when you were young or middle-aged or old. In your memory, it is just part of your life. So
of course
it's as if you did it when you were young. Like one example for me is I got a second degree at one point when I was a bit older.
Yeah.
And I didn't get it when I was, you know, like a teenager or my early 20s. I got it in my 30s. And but once I got it, it just didn't make a difference. It was like, you know what? That's my degree. And it's now in the bucket of my life. It's like the accomplishments of my life. So if like being a DJ is something that you want to do, and if playing an awesome show is something you want to do, it doesn't mean that you had to do it when you were in your 20s or whatever.
Oh no.
You could do it at any age, and it's still an awesome memory and an awesome
experience. Well, you see, okay, you've got to have certain things, but for example, if you have never played in front of a crowd of people and you want to do it, you can do it. There are many ways. And again, it's treading that thin line. Maybe what I'm about to explain now is not completely legal. It's maybe slightly illegal, but you can still get away with shit. Just start your own private party somewhere. Go to a nice farmer, some guy locally who's got a farm, a field, and say, or for example, maybe near you, there's a forestry, there's places that you can just go and walk and take the family. There's a lake, you know. I mean, who's to say? I might, well, I'm not going to go there, but at the moment. But summertime, you never know. But I mean, you know, there's nothing stopping you hiring a generator, taking your kit, hiring a little van and going out in the middle of nowhere and then promoting it when you're there. Just message all your friends. Whatever you do, if you're going to do this kind of shit, don't promote it beforehand, because if the people get hold of it, the wrong people, then you'll get the roads will be blocked. But just you know, very simple, just get out there, get a generator, get your kit, get a little PA system, a few lights, make sure you've got enough fuel, make sure you've got enough supplies to last you for like a weekend, and go and have a party and play your music. And once you're there, you set up, text a whole bunch of people, and believe me, it'll be an explosion. Everyone will text everybody, and before you know it, you'll have a whole bunch of people there, man. All good. And Ozan, you've disappeared, man. Ozan's gone. I'm sure he'll be back soon. Right. I want you to listen. Now, at the moment, I can't see the chat, so I do apologize if I'm not going to answer any questions. But the beginning of this track reminds me of a really well-known house tune that was clubby, but it became quite commercial towards its middle age, let's say. The beginning here just reminds me of 212. Okay, 212. I don't know. What do you think? All right. Again, I do apologize. I can't see the chat and I don't know where Ozan's gone. Maybe he's gone to the toilet. Who knows? All right. So let's find another tune. Let's go back. And if you just joined us, we are in Tribe. And this is virtual reality. So in front of me I have got a four-channel mixer, exactly like you'd expect to see in any big nightclub around the world. On my right, CDJ, on my left, a CDJ, and most of the functions on this kit is exactly what you'd expect to see on the high-end Nexus series. It's all good, man. Speed this sucker up. You can hear that? In fact, let's try something. Hold on. I'm gonna loop this shit up. Okay. Here we go. Here we go. Got a loop on that side. Again, just formed a bit of a loop there, and that was a, let's have a look. 1, 2, 3, 4, 2, 2, 3, 4, 3, 2, 3, 4, 4, 2, 3, 4, 1. So, 4-bar loop, there you go. All right, again, we're using tunes from Cryo Man. This is Crowd Funker. Okay, Ozan seems to have disappeared. I doubt very much whether he's disappeared because he just had enough. I think he's probably had a technical issue or something like that. So don't worry, guys. Okay, so again, I can't see the chat. I'm just gonna nip down now. You'll probably see my head disappear inside the mixer. I'm just checking out the chat, so bear with me a second. Excuse me, guys. Okay, guys, what I'm going to do, I've just chatted with Ozan now, and we're going to stop this session, and then we're going to restart. So, all being well, we will be back in about 5 minutes. So, as soon as this stream stops, hold tight, give us 5 minutes or even less, and we'll be straight back. Practice and enjoy. Thank you.